girlfriend goes crazy about it, but I'll check Instagram probably 50 times a day, if not more. Because I'm trying to keep an eye on what everyone's doing. Everyone. So the people I follow are people who are other photographers, picture editors, people that get their photograph taken a lot, like athletes or politicians. So I'm trying to keep an eye on what everyone else is doing. And the thing with that is, people don't post stuff they're not happy with. So they've got to be somehow satisfied. So if they're posting the photo, it's for a reason. You know, it might be that it's technically beautiful, might be the emotion's beautiful, it might be that it's, I don't know, it was hard for them to get the photo, they might have had to, you know, jump into the middle of a bushfire and try and get the photo. Like, there's all these different reasons. So you're seeing sort of the best on there. Unless you follow, you know, someone that posts a lot of photos of the cat, which, if they're really nice photos of the cat, sure. But if they're just like iPhone photos of the cat, I pretty quickly get rid of them because I'm spending like 50 times a day on this thing. I want it to be good.
So it always gets me on like Facebook and that,
I use Instagram firstly for that, and then secondary to push my brand, my name, my quality, my style, my what I'm shooting. Because a lot of the big bosses of the newspaper world are not in the country, so you know they don't see. You know, they're doing their high profile people in the city and their fancy businessmen, while I'm doing the country bumpkin, you know, having a rough trot with his NBN, you know, like, so yeah, I try and post nowadays every day or every second day. I try and post either in the morning or around, so probably about 10 o'clock. In the morning, or I'll post around probably 6 o'clock at night, and the reason for that is so people are checking on their way home from work and while they're waiting for dinner to be made, and in the morning they're checking it because they're bored at work or they're going out for their smoke or their whatever. In the morning they're checking it, in the evening they're checking it. So the theory is if you can try and get it in between there somehow, you're going to catch the best audience. I don't really do too much with hashtags. I just find that I get a lot of dodgy followers, like that aren't really that interested in me, or they're fake accounts because they're all, the fake accounts are linked to hashtags, so I try and avoid that. If I photograph the person and I know it's a nice shot, I'll try and ask them. So I don't know if you've realised, I've taken their names down and their details down for the caption, because in Lightroom, I don't know if you know, but you can put the metadata in. So these photos are branded with their name, so that in 50 years' time, if that kid becomes famous for lizard collections, I've got his photo, and I can be like, yeah, I got his photo. So, it's, you know, just a photo of, I don't know, my equipment sitting in a coffee shop, or it might be me trying to smooch my girlfriend in the street when she's running away from me, or whatever. So you're trying to, mostly try and keep it photography related, or, you know, give them a little hint of your personal life. But mine's all branding, so I don't, there's no photo, well, unless you really go back in time, there's not many photos of me on there. It's all my work. The work. So you got to try and find the balance. But see, some people like your personality, so they only follow you because of your personality. They don't care about your photos. So, yeah.
That's kind of where the stories is coming.
Yeah. So you can show a bit more of your personality without it being permanently there for, you know, like a new client to come along and see. Because when you're going for a job and you say, oh, you know, you know, Megan such and such, and they say, oh, yeah, nice to meet you, and they secretly go on Facebook you and Instagram you and Twitter you, they want to see all your cool photos. They want to see a photo of you and your beer on a Friday night. So, Yeah, there's a bit of that sort of. That's the cool new feature of Instagram stories. And then the website, it should have some sort of web presence. Some people say less is more. I'm like, give them a heap of stuff and let them sort of decide. But, you know, the heap of stuff needs to still be heaps of good stuff. Can't be riffraff. And then Google... Oh, hello.
Yeah, just proceed. Sorry, mate.
Google likes blogging. Google likes changes. Google likes updates. So I'm trying to get my head around trying to blog more. There's one photo I did the other day which I'll blog about. Oh, that's not my computer.
Sorry, mate.
That's okay. Can't show you. So trying to blog about things. So blogging about things that, for example, this was just something I wanted to go and do. Got offered access to work for nothing. I wanted to get access to the training, the Australian... Work for access is definitely the thing. And it all nearly paid off for me because down the bottom here, there's tags. See down here, there's tags. Now, these tags are sort of relevant to your website, but then also that Google likes them too. So some lady in Melbourne, some PR company, searched SES training in Google, I'm pretty sure. And she's found my website now. She said, how much for some photo there? And it's like $150. So if she wanted that photo, then it all would have been worth it because she would have bought that and I could have tried to do a deal with her to get three instead of one. So sometimes you aren't working necessarily. You've got like a purpose. Like I knew a couple of the guys who were mates with them. I was invited along. So it's pretty cool to do. Whilst Joe Hall, who's Channel 9's host, I've posted the photo because it's very, I would consider it to be a very high quality picture of somebody who's quite popular on TV.
She's got
And I've also wanted to show off how much effort's gone into making this damn woman look good, because she was 25. She was 25 minutes late, and I had no time for that. So I was like, bam, 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 we're done, and I was out of there, packed it all back in.
You were 25 minutes late.
Well, yeah, well, she would have been crazy with me, but it's like that. It's like that TV show. Thank God you're here. As soon as you turn up, everyone's like, hey, and that's when I start my ramble. Having a web presence is very well, you guys wouldn't have known about this. They haven't known about this, would they?
Nah.
So even just funny stories. This was when Benny's TAFE was last year or year before?
Yeah, so this was our Melbourne trip last year.
So I got an Uber.
Mark was in town. We had a studio booked in Melbourne.
Yeah.
And I was like, what are you doing on Sunday afternoon? Oh, nothing. Why don't you come to our studio? We've got booked.
So I caught an Uber with all my crap. And this bloke was pretty interested to why I had so much crap. And so I got talking to him and, you know, he was pretty jazzy looking bloke. I swear he changed his pants, but he had, I'm sure he had dark pants on. Anyway, that's a story for another day. But, anyway, this guy was a pretty good looking bloke, you know, cool face, nice bloke, chatting in the car. So I just said to him, I said, I'm a photographer, we've hired a studio this afternoon, not that I had, but, you know, I was bullshitting him. And I gave him my business card. I said, I'm here till 4:30. If you're interested, here's my number, here's my email address, give me a buzz if you're floating back around this area. Anyway, so I get this phone call and he's like, yeah, I'm out the front. And so we got him in for like, I don't know, 20 minutes or something. and shot these pictures. So,
He changed his pants. Maybe
that's
some weird
unexplained
stains.
That was just a funny story and some nice pictures. So even just blogging about that or the recent jobs you've done is pretty good.
That's cool, man.
Yeah, just being having a web presence.
So, I'm not going to say you're not a legit photographer because you truly have. It's written on your payslip, and there's nothing more legit than what's written on your payslip. But there was a point where you were projecting yourself into the career path you wanted. Yeah. Like, there was a point where you're a kid with a D90 on a push bike chasing trains.
Yep.
But you were still you still had polo shirts that said Mike Jester Photographer.
Yeah.
And you didn't say Mike Jester Photographer in training. And your Instagram, don't have a lot more photos of trains on it than it does now, still said Mike Jester, Euroa Photographer.
Yeah.
So I think there's, and what I'm hoping you guys take away is that there's a real power in just telling people what you are.
Fake it till you make it.
Yeah, or make it till you make it kind of thing. Like, I mean, you can get yourself into a little bit of trouble biting off an entire wedding when you're not quite ready for it. But most of the time, you rise to the occasion and you get there. So, you know what I mean? Like, just tell them how you are.
I just have a fear of, like, letting people down.
Alright, we'll start off
shooting. I do it all the time. I delivered a job the other day, it was a $900 job, and I'm just sitting there going, I don't know.
I don't think it goes away.
It's a creative thing. It's like, are you ever satisfied? No, you're never satisfied. Never. Never. It's like, there's things that, like, it's things you could have done differently every time.
Yeah.
It's like yesterday, I'll show you the photo yesterday. It's it's shit.
You ready?
Yeah.
Is that my DJ? It's a lacing, it's built
in your mind. No, I don't know if your connection's still on please, but
how do you log out on these computers?
Yeah, I've got Apple.
I've stuffed your computer.
Have
I? Well, I'm not stuffed it, but I feel like that wasn't like
that. Oh no, yeah, it's supposed to be like that. See?
And I think I've somehow stopped your recording, but not.
Yeah, I think.
Oh,
it ran out.
Oh no, it worked.
Dropping it'll do that.
Yeah. Oopsie. So, I did a photo. Hopefully no one's related to anybody, but so this was a job. This was a job for The Age in Melbourne. Now, when you get a job for The Age in Melbourne, it's not that you prioritise it more than your local jobs, but you know people are seeing, you know the top people in the industry are seeing the photo. So when we file our pictures, they go in our local archive. When I file these pictures, they go into the National Archive. So it's like every important picture editor there is in the country will see this photo arrive on their desk. So pressure's on a bit.
Yeah.
And so, my first problem was I had to photograph this photo of her when she was like 17 or something, 16 or something. And I wanted her to hold it in her hands because she's like 70 something or 90 something, whatever how old she is. And her hands are like far more wrinklier and more interesting than mine.
So is that her hand or yours?
That's mine. She wasn't overly happy with that and sort of started getting argumentative about my impression of wrinkles and was trying to tell me about all that. Yeah. And so, first problem, didn't get the photo I wanted. Second problem was no way I could talk her into it. Third problem was like, they wanted a hand in it. And I'm like, oh my God, I'm gonna have to go down the street and find an old lady to hold this damn thing. But I did, but it was borderline what I was gonna have to do is just go find an old person to hold the damn thing.
Slightly unethical.
So here's this lady who doesn't like wrinkles, doesn't like pictures of herself. But like, why she agreed to this photo, I have no idea. Like, she knows somebody that somehow agreed to it. And so, she just hard the photograph.
Yeah.
And, yeah, I got some good stuff, but it's not what I wanted. It's not what I wanted at all. And she's just like, so she had a carer there? So the carer, like, you know, takes her out and be social with her and helps feed her or whatever she does. And so they're having this conversation, and then there's this random photographer in their room. So I'm trying to like interrupt their conversation, try and get her to do what I want, and smile, look at me, try look at me, look at me. Can you please look at me? Like, so you just
one of those megaphones.
Yeah, look at me. quite difficult. The only photo is this photo. This one here is my favourite because I've literally got to a point where I'm just saying stupid crap to try and make this lady laugh and look at me. Like, so what I'm trying to say is, I'm trying to say that you're never satisfied. Someone will look at that photo and go, oh, it's a great photo. But you know that, like, it was so hard. Like, I was warned that this lady would take some time to photograph, but I didn't think it should be so anti-photos.
Yeah.
Like, but then you strike lucky with this job. And then you start lucky with this job, but this lady is so goddamn nice that she will do anything for you. I don't know for a barista, but she would just do whatever, you know, just talk random stuff with her, you know, just get her doing whatever you want.
So
why
don't you get a word in edgeways?
Eh?
I said, so why don't you get a word in edgeways with her?
Oh, well, you know it. So, beautiful photos, like, and just happy to do whatever. You know, give me your time. You know, oh, yep, sit there, do this. Okay, let's try and get the dog back over again. Yep, let's try and get the dog back over again. Yep, let's try and get the damn dog back over again. So you sort of, sometimes it just comes down to this subject, and it's also sometimes it's how you are on the day. Like, I probably wasn't that stressed out about this photo. I don't know why, because when I first turned up to the house, I was like, oh dear, what am I going to do for a photo? It's this tiny little unit. I'm like, oh man.
It looks pretty dark too.
Yeah. So, that looks pretty Mickey Mouse, doesn't it?
big screen.
Like, I walked out of that and going, yeah, couldn't do much better with what I got given. There's not much more I probably could have done. Like, Ruth, this is nothing against your mate, I don't know her. But, you know, can't have a lie on her belly, because she's an old lady, can't do that, no. You can't shoot her too wide with her head close to the thing, can't do that. You know, not saying she's a big lady, but she's not this supermodel thin, you know, size 9 plastic anorexic thing. You can't do all this stuff, so you are sort of locked into certain scenarios, but you also, you know that what your client wants. So I knew that the A's, the Fin Review, have a style, and so the style is not jamming her right close to the camera, whilst the border male styles probably get her quite close to the camera, fill the frame as much of her as you can without making it look bad. So that's why this one's a little bit more spacey, a bit more home-like, a bit more featurey.
I like that one, and I like the lamp in this, like, corner.
Yeah. River. So yeah, there's scenarios you get locked into that you have to work around.
Mark, Jesse?
Thank you, thank you, Mark.
Thank you.